Supremes. As requested by Kimura. Got a couple great songs. Get them on your playlist. All right. Happy Monday. We're on, hold on. All right. Happy Monday. And hello, friends. Welcome to another week of e-learning. And welcome to Mr. Keneally's desktop. All right, this week, hitting on some oil in Texas. Arguably, most important economic influence on Texas. So, you know, that and cattle, you can really take your pick. All right, so we're going to start today with not the first, but one of the first and certainly the biggest, you know, early oil discovery was at Spindletop in Beaumont, Texas. Here's a most well-known picture probably. So it was when they struck oil here. They knew that they had found something big, all right, big, all right? So the Spindletop Gusher blew for 9 days at about 100 barrels per day, okay? So let me bring that pick back up. All right, so they're going about 100 barrels of oil a day. That thing's about 100 feet in the air. That went for 9 days because what you have to do is when you strike oil is that, you know, you're hopefully you know, piping as you go, and then when that comes out, then you've got to get a cap on it, okay, or a lid, okay, so you've got to put that lid in, and then you can control the flow, you can direct it to, you know, the barrels or wherever you're storing the oil. Well, it took them 9 days because this was coming out with such force, all right, it took them 9 days to get it on, I think it was Coach Holt put this picture of Gushers. All right. Oh, well, okay. I guess we're not seeing the GIF of Gushers. We can see it there. But it reminded me of, you know what? Once the last time I had a Gusher? And so when I went to my once-a-week shopping trip, all gloved up and masked up, I got me some Gushers, and you know what? I thought we could just do a taste test, because I remember these as, like, such a treat. You know, because my mom didn't buy a whole lot of junk. And so if you could get Gushers, all right, that was some quality stuff. But, you know, I just don't know if they hold up. So I thought, oh, yeah, see that shape? Oh, yeah. Tremendous. And then, oh, boy, what a tough bet. Only one blue. Jeez, look at all these oranges. That's a tough draw for me. All right, but luckily, I got a six-pack, so I'm going to be all right. You can kind of see the filling inside there. All right. And ooh. You know what? Here's the thing. Let me get a blue one because. Oh. Ooh. Has a bad aftertaste. There was no really gushing. It's not gushing. It's like. It's got barely any filling in there. You know what? Now blue. See? No, I got gypped. That blue. That's good. That's good. Let me get a green. Let me get a green. Looks like it has like an orange. Orange is filling. Oh, yeah, it does. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that one's good, but I tell you what, these orange ones, not good. Not good. You know what, though? Oh, it tastes like is it reminds me more of a fruit roll-up than a fruit snack. I think they just like, oh, they all have a bad aftertaste. Oh, hold on. Oh. Oh. Oh, my gosh. Oh. All right, that's bad. I think it's like they, it seems like they just take the leftover fruit roll-up, squish it up, squirt a little something in there. Okay, not good. Anyways, Gusher at Spindletop. You know, one of the biggest finds, and that's really what started bringing people into Texas to really start looking, because people that discovered Spindletop and were able to tap that oil supply, they got rich, all right? Filthy, filthy rich. All right, there's a quick film. That must have been Trenthill. This is Trenthill's idea of a film, all right? There's a quick little video here on Spindletop. I'm not going to watch the whole thing here. It's really slow and my internet's down. I mean, it's supposed to start playing on its own. Look, I'm loading. I'm loading. Oh, a gusher is stuck in my teeth now, too. Ah. You know, I give it about a 3 out of 10. Oh, jeez. Lysol, ad for Lysol. You can't even get Lysol in the stores right now. What are they running an ad for it? All right, here we go.
It's 1900, the dawn of the greatest consumer boom the world has ever seen.
Mm-hmm. This is from America's Story of Us.
Without the discovery of what lies beneath the Texas dirt.
Oh, boy. Ooh, great little video work. This guy, pretty good narration. I do feel like black gold.
The Hamill brothers, oil men, young, rugged, ambitious, known as some of the best in the business.
Kind of cute too.
The field the Hamill brothers are hired to drill will become the stuff of legend.
Yeah, see, they're laying that pipe in there.
Spindletop.
Oh.
Prospectors have tried drilling at Spindletop before. Previous wells here came up empty.
Yeah, it kept breaking their drill bits.
Lousy for drilling. Earlier attempts hit hundreds of feet of sand and collapsed.
So then the hole would collapse in on itself. They'd have to start over.
Fighting for every foot.
But these guys.
Normally, these kinds of rigs pump water into the borehole to support its walls. Is mud. The Hamels have been drilling for over 2 months.
2 months? My gosh. Oh, boy. There we go. Better watch out. There we go. That's a shot we were looking for. Spindletop. All right, they're excited. You get the idea. Okay, they're going to be rich. So, if you are... I don't like it when that part shows up. All right, so if you're in regular history, you can peace out now. If you are in pre-AP, stick with me a couple more minutes. I'm going to go over your assignment, changing it up just a bit. I just want to give you a little bit more creativity, you know, opportunity this week. You know, get you away from the discussion questions so much. So when you go, I'm on student view here. Okay. So when you get into your modules this week, okay, Click on modules just like you always do. All right. This is like our practice version that we use, and then we copy over from it. Okay. You'll see same setup. Day one, day two, day three, day four, day five. You know, it's a couple things. On day one, there's an e-learning survey. This is for the principals. They want to see sort of really what's going on. All right. So all your comments, you know, about math giving you so much work, or you're not being able to find stuff, you know, that you've been leaving for me, I've been trying to help people with, make sure you leave those comments. And honestly, make sure you're honest. Yeah. Give some good feedback. If everything's going fine, perfect. Say that. Okay. If you've having some issues, if it's in a particular subject area, let them know that, because we're ready to make changes to make this better for you if we can, okay? And then, so for this week's assignment, okay, you're already on the Spindletop video, okay? That's what you're watching right now, okay? So you may have even done this e-learning survey. I just figured that out. Okay, so anyways, you could fill out again if, you know, you decided you weren't honest and now you want to be honest. Actually, will it let you? I don't know. Anyways, you're going to begin the oil infographic, okay? You click on this. This has the slideshow embedded right here in it, okay? Apparently I haven't authorized it to use it, okay? If this happens to you, all right, and it can't see anything, click this link right here and we will open up the oil by numbers activity for you. Okay, and it said slides 1 through 4 for today. Okay, so you read through the directions. All right, on here, it's telling you about how you're going to create something that looks like this. Okay, but you can create it however you want. You don't have to have a road. Okay, but the key to this infographic is the numbers. Okay, we're looking at what are the numbers about oil. That's why the assignment is called Oil by the Numbers. Okay, see, even I title it here. Oil by the numbers activity. All right. So this tells you, like, for day one, okay, you're going to go to this website and answer these questions. I think I may have answered them in the video. Oopsies. Okay. And then you'll find your assignment. Okay. If you go back to modules, I put the assignment because you're going to work on this on Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday, or for 3 days, or however you're doing your work. I put it at the bottom here. Okay. Oil infographic will be here all week. Click below to work on the assignment. So you click on the oil infographic assignment. And come on, pop up correctly. Yeah, I logged in with my daughter's login here, so it would open up like you guys do. Okay, now you can click right here. My suggestion, click open in assignments. Okay, because this is where the submit button is. Okay, and then just open the assignment. So it should say your name first and last. Put your name here, okay? And so then all you've got to do to get started is just click up here, delete this part, and then all that will be left will be your name, okay? So now you're going to create the infographic, all right? Now, a few reminders. We've used this before in my class. A few reminders. If you want to type text, get yourself a text box. You can start typing in it, okay? If you can't type this fast yet, you know, start working on a typing class, all right? All right, if you want it inside a shape, all right, pick any of these shapes. Ooh, banner. Ooh, I love me a banner. Okay, and then you got to double click. Then again, you can type in here, okay? You can change the font size, you know, everything that you would normally do. Please don't use Arial font. It's so ugly. Okay, you can send, oh, look, I got to click this more option here so I can get to my centering my text, okay? You know, if you want lines, you know, if you want to show like this right here, it leads to this, click there. You can change the line color. You can change the thickness. If you need a nice thick line to really emphasize your point, okay, go ahead. You can even do a dotted line. All right, so a whole bunch of options. Feel free to play around with it. Be creative. Also, look, if it, you know, all right, just make sure if you don't want, you know, any more lines or shapes or whatever, just you can click here and then that brings you back to your regular. Okay, so look, be creative. Okay, but make sure that your minimum here is you're answering these questions. How high did the oil reach in the air? Okay, so you might put a big 100 feet and then a little description with a text box or something, okay? Or you might do find an image. You know, you could do insert image, search on the web here, and then I'm going to search for the number 100. All right, boom, and then I want this one. So I'll just bring it right on over. All right. Be creative. Have fun with this. All right. Assignment. And, you know, kept it still simple. I mean, it's just two questions basically you're answering on this day one. And then each day one, day two, and day three, the directions, it will tell you which slide to go on. Okay. I think day two is here. Oh, look, I even put it... I guess you can't see me pointing. I even put it right there for you. That's day three. Then make sure, all right, let me go back. Okay, so you're done here. You get out of that. Make sure when you're done, when you've done all 3 days worth of work, you're hitting that submit button. Okay? You hit that submit button because I can't see your work on this until you hit that submit. Okay? Now, I will be checking this any day. All right, all the days. All right, I'll start checking it on Monday a bit. You know, I'll get on there, check. I'll check it on Tuesday. Now, if you're not finished, but you still want me to look at it, go ahead and hit submit. Okay. Today, Junior. All right, go ahead and hit submit. And if your internet is working properly, there you go. Boom, it's submitted. But now, you can't make any changes, okay? Because it turned it into me. Then when you want to go, okay, so you hit submit, and then maybe you come back over here, you hit the help button, and you ask me a question like, hey, Mr. Keneally, can you get on and check mine, make sure I'm doing it right, okay? And I'll get in there, and I'll be able to see it because you hit submit, okay? And then when you're ready to work on it again the next day or the next hour, whenever, you just make sure you hit unsubmit. Then it gives you back ownership of the Google Drawing, and then boom, you can just open it back up and get back to work again, okay? And I'll have answered your question, whatever. All right, so seems like that video has gone on long enough. Please, let me know if you have any questions, all right? Little Supremes to take us out. Let me make sure we covered everything. Oh, yeah, we did. Get the Supremes on your playlist. It's gonna make your day. There's some good songs. Have a good one.